Federation. He felt that someone may have done it on purpose. The Federation, a few of them, felt he wasn't trading hard enough. There's his mom in the stands as he takes the ice. But right now, things seem to be getting better. We'll see. Brian Joubert coming off a bronze medal at Skate America in second place after the short program.
Joubert's skating is about power and precision, big linear movements, not the subtlety of Jeffrey Buttle. He opens with a quad combination. Quad toe, good height, a little turnout, and he turns it just into a plane jump. For all the talk about the quads, not one of the top guys has landed a clean one. Next jump, triple axel. Much better. Brian's power in the air position can be seen here. Triple flip, triple toe. 9.5 base value. Opening is a little bit up and down the ice to jump passes. Triple Lutz there, very good. Lacking the transitional quality of Jeffrey Buttle and Emmanuel Sandu and Plushenko.
Soap opera atmosphere surrounding Joubert's last year or year and a half with the coaching changes, the problems with the current personnel at the Federation in France. Didier Gayeguet has now become his quote-unquote personal counselor. Gayeguet, you may remember, was the former head of the French Federation who was suspended by the ISU for his role in the Salt Lake City fiasco. And now he's going to take a more active role in Joubert's training and making sure that he's working hard on the ice. Some interesting character.
Well, Didier has been behind the scenes throughout Brian's career. And I think that he actually is very good at analyzing the fact that Joubert didn't work hard enough before Skate America, and he is the catalyst behind getting him back on track. Not to defend him.
You can defend him if you'd like.
The positions in these spins, not quite stretched, but he's getting extra levels here for the variations. Step sequence a little bit basic for Joubert. This Grand Prix season is about convincing the judges who the Olympic champion is. And your whole goal, like a political campaign, should be to say, this is the program that's going to seal the deal, the one that's going to be in the history books. This is the costume. These are the movements that people are going to play in the replays for years to come.
Trying to plant some images in the backs of the minds of potential Olympic judges, Brian Joubert. Did we see glimpses of the Joubert we expect to see, Paul?
Well, he's way stronger than he was at Skate America, but missing the quad toe triple double combination at the beginning was sort of a rocky start. And you'll see right here, the hips just get a little bit around. He has a great air position, but just can't hold the landing to go into the triple toe double loop. And the triple flip, triple toe shows a great strength. The air position right there, a little bit loose, but here on the triple toe, nice, good height. Just a real solid jumper and a great landing position. Again, triple loop, just a little bit leaning, a little under-rotated, puts his hand down there. That won't count as a fall because he wasn't supporting all of his weight with his arm.
Now, he needs 143.94 to win. He has scored higher than that in the past. 71.80 for program components. Still no one matching Buttle in terms of the artistic side. 138.86, that's not enough. So you hear some whistles, some catcalls here in Paris. 210.41. Joubert may be back on track a little bit, but he